today we have a very special guest, Mr. Binoy Acharya, the founder of Unnati Organization. Unnati Organization for Development Education is a voluntary non-profit organization which aims to promote social inclusion and democratic governance so that the vulnerable sections of the society are empowered and can participate in the mainstream development and decision-making process. Mr. Acharya, we welcome you to One World, One Fight Leadership Interview Series. How is Unnati addressing the challenges posed by COVID-19 pandemic?
I want to state that since 25th March, starting from the lockdown, our staff continue to stay in their respective workstations. And they, at the initial days, particularly the early, late March and early April, they were involved in a lot of relief work, arranging transport, coordinating between agencies to provide support whoever in need. And by mid of April, when there is a lot of people didn't have money to buy even their food, our staff got involved in relief work, particularly reaching to the most vulnerable and supporting the frontline workers to not only do their conventional work, but also to work on building awareness about COVID and providing support.
How useful have been your thematic centers in the current situation?
We have three thematic areas. One is called social inclusion and empowerment. Second one is governance and social accountability. And third one is disaster risk reduction. And I must tell you that all these three result areas, we are continuing our work with current, kind of making it more relevant to the current situation. We have been working with panchayats. It is both with regard to governance and disaster risk reduction. After all, COVID is a public health emergency. We are working with gram panchayats to develop COVID response plan. And in that, panchayats have been trained to how to conduct, how they can conduct awareness program, how they can support social distancing and hand washing at public places like hospitals, sub-centers, PDAs, Anganwadis. So that has been continued. And some of the panchayats we have helped in terms of also developing quarantine homes and contact tracing. So panchayats with local youth have been doing this very effectively. with regard to social accountability, you know, this is the time where social accountability of public programs must be done at the highest order, because we have additional public programs, Prime Minister Garib Kalyan Yojana, that need to reach the most vulnerable, including free ration, including 500 rupees every month to the Jan Dhan accounts, and Prime Minister Kisan Samman Yojana, all that need to reach people. So our staff have been working at the grassroots level in coordination with block and taluka level functionaries so that these programs reach the people effectively, so that not a single entitlement is lost out. People must receive their entitlements.
How would you assess NGO's response to the pandemic?
I must tell you that during this COVID time, it is a difficult time, but NGO collaboration has kind of increased significantly. I must emphasize two particularly significant our association with our NGO fraternity. One with Priya in Delhi, CYSD in Bhubaneswar, Sahbhagi Shikshan Kendra in Lucknow, Samarthan in Bhopal, and Unnati in Ahmedabad. We worked along with senior academicians and bureaucrats to develop a migrant worker policy, because our Interest and Migrant Act has not been effective. Even though the migrant workers in their destination state contribute significantly for the economic growth, but states have not really provided them adequate support both for welfare and social protection. So this particular migrant policy is primarily for the destination states, but also it is linked to the source states. And particularly our emphasis is how the source state and destination state, they can develop MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, so that these workers are registered, they are protected, their interest is safeguarded, and their welfare is taken care of. And this policy note has been sent to chief ministers, the secretary labor and employment of different state governments, and now with different state governments we are trying to work with them. Another very interesting initiative we were particularly involved in is there is 60 CSOs came together nationally and formed a response to COVID called RCRC, and it has done tremendously good amount of work. In fact, it is conducting a ground level research in different rounds and finding out what is happening. And I must tell you that it found out in mid-May that a lot of people who are having liquidity problem, naturally they don't have money in their pocket. So to meet their family needs, the health needs, the agriculture, kharif season is coming, that requirements, people require money. So RCRC has been working with the donor community and NBFCs, non-banking financial corporations, to provide liquidity, particularly interest-free liquidity. Of course, the interest will be taken care of by some other philanthropic institutions or a foundation. But at least the kharif crop, they are able to grow. Also, RCRC has worked very closely with government with regard to reviving KVK, Krishi Vigyan Kendras, how they can be more effective, and how to make MG energy more effective. These are two work which RCRC has done very effectively. So I must tell you that NGO collaboration during the pandemic, I think, is unparalleled.
What would be your prescription for NGOs to address social inclusivity challenges?
Perhaps in normal time we have not worked that closely, but in these time our relationship with our fraternity has increased. I think this is also accepted by Niti Aayog and the Ministry of Home Affairs, that NGOs are doing incredible amount of work. Civil society has really responded very positively for the welfare of the people who are in distress in this pandemic.
It seems the world has to live with COVID-19. How should NGOs prepare for it?
With regard to how we are going to continue our work, I think we will continue our work with serious restrictions. Take for example, NGOs are the social or human face of the development. Without meeting people, without having our field visits, our work cannot be effective. But there are serious limitations. And as I told from the beginning of this pandemic, we have been meeting people. We are going to the villages with keeping appropriate, adequate safety measures, social distancing, hand washing, and continue to work with them. We'll continue to do that. Of course, we cannot have meeting with large number of people. Even village meetings cannot be done with 30 people. It can be smaller meetings. And we have found that smaller meetings can be made effective. That requires more frequent meetings. That requires more lateral level understanding. Take for example, if a village level we prepare one person, that one person need to now train another 10 person, because that person with social distance can do it. And we have demonstrated in our field work that on different themes, the village level volunteers can reach out to other people and capacity building can be carried out. So, but the question will be that in this pandemic, most sufferers will be children. The children who are now learning motor skills, coordination skills, or they require additional food, nutrition, they are being left out. These are serious limitation to it. Similarly, children who don't have access to smartphone or even television, they are finding it difficult to cope up with education. Many health requirements need to be compromised, cannot be addressed, because there's a risk to go to a hospital, particularly elder people, pregnant women. There's a risk to it.
How is Unnati preparing for the post-pandemic era?
Things will not be as usual. In fact, in my assessment, We are now productive 50%. So, with regard to our conventional work, and I think that 50% productivity, the 50% efficiency will continue for some time. And any amount of online digital support cannot compensate. We can do, of course, other things. Take, for example, our capacity building of the community leaders have now improved. But certain programs are going to suffer. And that's why we need to work hand in hand with frontline workers, with smaller teams, how we can reach out to them so that nobody is in distressing condition. The distress must be addressed because a lot of people are in distress. So that need to be addressed. And we need to also improve our online skills. Take, for example, there are many online platforms, there are many softwares where you can do group discussions, where you can use different other mechanisms. I was told that there are softwares like Mural, Mentimeter, which can be used with online programs to have group discussions, to have writing in the flip charts. So all that can be done. So we as an institution, I think, we're not defeated by pandemic. We're continuing our work from day one. Of course, wherever possible, we don't want to travel unnecessarily. We want to do the urgent work most. But I think our preparedness is there. Thank you.
It was really nice talking to you, Mr. Acharya, and it was really a great and informative session. Thank you.